What's happening, everybody? Sean with Reactions to the Classics. And today we got a song reaction for one of our patrons, Mr. Keen. We have the great Boston track, Foreplay / Longtime off their super famous debut album. Before we get into that, if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Hit the big red subscribe button if you haven't already. And if you would like us to react to a song or support us anyway, check out the Patreon link below as the patrons make this thing go. Also, check out our live streams every Wednesday at 1 o'clock Central Time and Friday night at 6 o'clock Central Time on Twitch. The link is below. So, let's talk a little bit about this song. Now, there's actually a review of the debut album of Boston up on the channel, but my son Trey did it with one of his friends, Ben, way early on in the channel. So you can check that out if you want. I've only ever listened to this album one time. I don't remember this song, but it was written by Tom Scholz, as all the stuff was. It was their second single. Went to number 22 in the U.S., top 10 in a lot of other places, including Canada. He said it might have been the first song he ever wrote, maybe as far back as 1969, and it was the first one that he recorded. So it's got some history to it. Obviously, the Foreplay at the start of the song is an instrumental that goes on for a couple minutes, and then we get into the Longtime, the audio portion of it. As always, if you're a regular watcher of the channel, I'll have the lyrics up on my computer. I will not say anything until it's over with, and then I'll give you my reaction to it. Once again, thanks, Mr. Keen, and let's jump into it. I can just imagine Tom down in his basement weighing this down on the two track. guitar so tremendous, as expected with Boston. So smooth, man. Wow, Tom Scholz and the boys from Boston. Once again, a tune that I've heard one time, didn't remember it at all, has some similarities to More Than a Feeling, just a little bit, you know, in the catchiness of it. Obviously, the instrumental to start is an interesting way to do it. There's only 8 tracks on this debut album, and the debut album is obviously famous and was the best-selling debut album of all time in the United States until Guns N' Roses came along with Appetite for Destruction. So they held that for a long time. It was recorded in the basement of Tom's house, if you guys don't know that. The studio, or the record label, wanted him to go into a studio, but he decided to create this in the basement. And just so well produced, just like More Than a Feeling. Tom's an incredibly smart guy, graduated from MIT, was working for Polaroid at the time, took a leave of absence to just bang out this album. So all those things are so fascinating to me. After we get through the obvious awesome instrumental and Foreplay, then we get to Longtime, and he's really just talking to this girl. It's been such a long time, I think I should be going, and time doesn't wait for me, it keeps on rolling. I've got to keep chasing a dream, I've got to be on my way. wish there was something I could say. So I don't know if he's talking about the music dream, because you got to chase that dream while you can, and he's got to move on because this girl's over here and he's got to go chase his dream. And then the hook is so catchy. Well, I'm taking my time. I'm just moving along. You forget about me after I've been gone, and I take what I find. I don't want no more. It's just outside of your front door, and then it's been such a long time. He talks about getting so lonely, but he can't forget about her. And then in the very last verses, he's just like, I think it's been such a long time. I think I should be going, and I've got to keep on chasing that dream, though I may never find it, which is what so many musicians are up against. I'm just always behind it, maybe just a little bit behind it. And he's thinking if he moves on, then maybe he can get there. Just a fantastic track. Obviously, the guitar solo is a standout, but I think the vocals are also just tremendous. The clapping in the background, just such a tremendously put together song. On first listen, I'm going to give that an 8.0, which is a really high score. Like I said, I've heard it once before. I don't remember it. So it really is like a first listen for me. I just never really got into this album just because I really never had an avenue to do it. I was 5 years old when it came out and just never gave it a spin. So once again, thank you, Mr. Keen. What a tremendous pick. And if you like this, like I said, give it a big thumbs up. It really helps us in the YouTube algorithm. And check out the channel. We upload stuff every single day. And until next time, I will see you.